Hello students, today our lesson is multiplication and division, primary 4, first term mathematics. Page numbers are textbook page numbers 80 to 112. Objectives of the lesson: multiply two-digit or three-digit numbers by one-digit numbers. Divide two-digit or three-digit numbers by one-digit numbers. Solve word problems involving multiplication and division. Find an answer to a division word problem by rounding the answer up or down after division. Our first topic is multiplication. First, we have to learn multiplication without regrouping. Example: Ari has a set of 13 crayons. Min gives him another set of 13 crayons. He now has two sets of crayons. How many crayons does Ari have altogether? We can write the steps above as a simple method. To find this answer, you have to follow two steps. Here you have the steps. Step 1. First, we want to multiply ones. 3 ones multiplied by 2. 6 ones. 3 times 2 is 6. Then, as the second step, we should multiply the tens. 1 ten multiplied by 2. 2 tens. 1 times 2 is 2. Now, as the final answer, the product of 13 and 2 is 26. Here, you have some examples. Multiply. We'll see our first question. 21 want to multiply by 4. First, you should multiply ones. 4 times 1 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. Then the product is 84. Then second one, 40 need to multiply by 2. 40 times 2. First, you should multiply ones. 2 times 0, 0. 2 times 4 is 8. Then the answer is 80. Third example. 33 need to multiply by 3. 3 times 3 is 9. Again, in tens place also you have 3. Then you have to multiply again 3 times 3. Then the answer is 9. Then the final answer you can take 99. Check this example. 214 you have to multiply by 2. We have 3 numbers now. It means 3 places. First, we have to multiply 1's place. 2 times 4 is 8. Then the 10's place. 2 times 1 is 2. Then finally you should multiply hundreds place. What is the number in hundreds place? Yes, 2. 2 times 2 is 4. Now the product of that example 428. Then next example. There also you have 3 places. 221. Want to multiply by 4. Then, what we have to do first? Yes, we should multiply 1's place first. 4 times 1 is 4. Then, the 10's place. 4 times 2, do you know the answer? Yes, 4 times 2 is 8. Then again, you have 2 is in 100 place. 4 times 2 again. Then, again 8 is coming. Then, final answer. Tell me the final answer. 884. Very good. Then, next example. 302 times 3. 302 need to multiply by 3. 3 times 2, 6. 3 times 0, yes. 3 times 0 is 0. Then, hundreds place, you have 3. 3 times 3, 9. Then, final answer, 906. Now, I think you can do textbook page number 83. Then we have to learn multiplication with regrouping. Here also you have an example. Find the product of 56 and 2. It means 56 times 2. Now here also you have to follow two steps. We'll see what are those steps. Step 1. Multiply the ones. It means you have to multiply 6 ones by 2. 6 times 2, 12 ones. Regroup 12 ones into 1 10 and 2 ones. Because we can't keep 12 in ones place. We should keep only one number, 2. Then we have to take 1 10 to tens place. Then check step 2. Multiply the tens. What is the tens place here? 5. Then you have to multiply 2 times 5. It means 5 tens multiplied by 2. Then the answer is 10 tens. But earlier also we have 1 ten. Then you have to add that too. 1 ten plus 10 tens. Altogether we have 11 tens. Regroup 11 tens into 100 and 110. Then we have to keep that 1 in hundreds place. Now our final answer is the product of 56 and 2 is 112. Here you have example 1. Find the product. Check first one. 79 need to multiply by 5. So you have to write the answer. First we have to multiply ones place. What is the answer for ones place? 5 times 9, 45. Then can you write 45 in ones place? No, you should write 5 in ones place and 4 we have to take to tens place. Then you have to multiply tens place. 5 times 7. 7 tens need to multiply by 5. Then answer is 35. Then with that 4 tens, all together we have 39 tens. Then we have to write 9 in tens place and 3 in hundreds place. The product of 79 and 5 is 395. Check this example. Second example. 86 need to multiply by 4. Here also you have to multiply ones place first. 4 times 6, 24. Then you have to write 4 in ones place and 2 tens we have to take to the tens place. Then you have to multiply tens place. What is the number in tens place? 4 times 8. 8. 4 times 8 is 32. Then earlier we have another 2 tens. We have to add that 2 tens to 32. Then all together 34. Then 4 we have to write in tens place and 3 we have to write in hundreds place. 344. Next example, 287. 287 need to multiply by 2. Tell me the answer for that one. Yes, 574. How did you take it? First we have to multiply 1's place. 2 times 7 is 14. So you have to write 4 in 1's place and 1 we should take to the 10's place. Then 2 times 8 is 16. We have to add earlier 10 for that. 17 tens. 17's tens. We have to write 7 there. And 1 we have to take to the 100's place. Then 2 times 2 is 4 and we have to add earlier 100 for that. 4 add 1, 5. Then final answer is 574. Then next example also you have 3 places. It means 100 places also there. 252. Want to multiply by 3. Then 3 times 2 is 6. That one we can write directly. Okay, then 10th place. 3 times 5. 3 times 5 is 15. It means 5 tens need to multiply by 3. Answer is 15. Then we have to write only 5. We have to take 100 to the 100's place. Then 3 times 2 is 6. 200s need to multiply by 3. Then we have to add earlier 100 for that one. Then 3 times 2 is 6. 6 add 1, 7. Then next example. 132 need to multiply by 7. It means 7 times 2, 14. We have to write 4 there and we should take 1 to the next place. 7 times 3, 21. Then we have to add earlier 1 and all together 22. Then here also you have to write 1 number only. So we have to write 2 and other 2 we have to take to the 100's place. 7 times 1 is 7. 7 add 2, 9. We have to write in 100's place. So the final answer is 924. Did you understand that one? Yes. Then the final example is 124 need to multiply by 8. Try to do and tell me the answer. Yes, very good. 992 is the answer. This is your second example. Match. See this example. Now you have 3 butterflies and 3 flowers. Butterflies with the multiplication and flowers with the products. Okay. First one, look. 69 want to multiply by 4. What is the answer for that? Yes, 276 is the answer. Second one, 426 multiplied by 3. 426 times 3. 1278. Third multiplication, 318 need to multiply by 5. Answer is 1590. I think now you can do textbook page number 88. Our next topic is division, quotient and remainder. We'll see what are those. Check this example. Put 7 flowers into groups of 2. We have 7 flowers. We have to put into groups of 2. It means how many groups we can take? 3 groups we can take. Each group we have to put 2 flowers. Then we can take 3 groups. Then the remainder is 1. There are three groups of two flowers with one flower left over. We can write this division sentence as like this. 7 divided by 2 equal 3. Remainder is 1. Then the quotient is 3. Remainder is 1. When we divide a number by another, the answer we get is called the quotient. The amount left over is called the remainder. Our next topic is division without regrouping. This is your example. 28 divided by 2. We can write the steps above as a simple method. Step 1. This is your first step. 28 we need to divide by 2. First of all, we have to check 10's place. 2 is there. 2 divided by 2, 1. Then 1 10 multiplied by 2, 2 10's. So 2 10's divided by 2 equal 1 10. The answer is 1 for 10's place. Then step 2. Then you have to divide 1's place. 8 divided by 2. 4. 4 1's multiplied by 2 is 8 1's. Then, so 8 1's divided by 2, 4 1's. So these are the steps you have to follow. Then finally 28 divided by 2, the answer is 14. The quotient is 14. There is no remainder. Here you have some examples. Find the quotient and the remainder. This is your first example. 46 divided by 2. Then you have to find the answer like this. When we find the answer, we have as the quotient 23 and the remainder is 0. Second example. 25 want to divide by 2. This is the answer for that. Then what is the quotient here? 12 and the remainder is 1. Very good. Then third one, 34 divided by 3. 34 need to divide by 3. Then we have the answer. Then what is the quotient here? 11. Very good. Remainder 1. Very good. Then our final example. 72 need to divide by 6. This is the way you have to find that answer. Then our answer is as the quotient we can get 12 and the remainder is 1. I think now you can do test page number 94. Our next topic is division with regrouping. Here also you have an example. 43 need to divide by 2. We can write the steps above as a simple method. Step 1. This is your step 1. Divide the 10. First we should divide the tens. In tens place we have 4. 4 divided by 3. Then in 4 we have 1, 3. When we divide 4 by 3 we have only 1. Then the next one we have to multiply 3 times 1. 3 times 1 is 3. Then we have to subtract 3 from 4. Then 1. In 1's place we have 3. Then we should take it to down. Then all together we have 13 once. Then step 2. Divide the ones. Then when we divide 13 by 3, the answer is 4. 3 times 4 is 12. Then 12 need to subtract from 13. Then what is the remainder? We have 1. Then finally we can take the answer. It means the quotient 14, remainder is 1. Now we will see some examples. Find the quotient and the remainder. 73 need to divide by 4. Then you have to follow the steps and find the answer. Use long division. Quotient is 18, remainder is 1. Next one, 66 need to divide by 5. Then first you have to divide tens place. 6 need to divide by 5, then 1 is the answer, then 5 times 1 is 5, then need to subtract 5 from 6, then 1 we have, then we have to take 1 place number, it means 6, altogether 16 ones we have to divide by 5, then we can take 3 as the answer, 5 times 3 is 15, then 15 ones we should subtract from 16 ones, then answer is 1. Then remainder is 1 and the quotient is 13. Next example, 70 need to divide by 2. Then the answer is, it means the quotient is 35, remainder is 0. Next example, 58 need to divide by 3. 58 divide by 3, then the answer is quotient is 19, remainder is 1. Now you can do textbook page number 99. Our next topic is solving word problems using bar models. This is your example. A table cost $29. How much do 5 of these tables cost? Then we have to use the bar to find the answer for this. 1 unit, it means 1 table, $29. Like that 5. 1 unit equal to $29. Like that 5 means we have to multiply 29 by 5. The answer is $145. Next example. Mrs. Yap spends $530 every month. Mrs. Chua spends 4 times as much as Mrs. Yap. How much does Mrs. Chua spend each month? Then Mrs. Yap spends $530 for a month. Then Mrs. Chua spends 4 times as much as Mrs. Yap. Then 1 month $530, like that 4 means we have to multiply by 4. 530 need to multiply by 4. The answer is $2,120. Now you can do textbook page number 109 and 110. From these references, you can get more information about this lesson. That is the end of our lesson. Thank you.